Hi. Lyndon Byers here. Steve Burton, my buddy Steve Burton. You can't see him because he's driving. And I'm in the passenger seat, and we're doing an MTV view. See, check it out. Cool. All right, we're going to go for lunch, and we're going to talk to a few people today. So let's roll.
Ever since I was a young boy, I played the silver ball. From Soho down to Brighton, I must have played them all. But I ain't seen nothing like him in any amusement hall. That deaf, dumb, and blind kid sure plays a mean pinball. He stands like a statue, becomes part of the machine. Feeling all the bumpers, always play clean.
Adding yourself after anyone speaking in a nicer line to me?
Well, I like to follow. I play defense myself, and I like to watch all the defensemen. I like to watch Tim Horton, Richard Arnold, and I really think a lot of Terry Harper in Montreal.
Now, why did you decide to choose Boston?
Well, I think that Boston is building their team now, and I just like to be a part of their building.
Never seen him fall. That deaf, dumb, and blind kid sure plays a mean pinball. I thought I was the body table king, and I just handed my pinball crown to him. Disciples needed him, and he just does the rest. He's got crazy flipping fingers, never seen him fall. That deaf, dumb, and blind kid sure plays a mean pinball.
Welcome back, my friends, to the show that never ends. We're so glad you could attend. Come inside, come inside. There behind the glass stands a real blade of grass. Be careful as you pass. Move along, move along. Come inside, the show's about to start. Guaranteed to blow your head apart. Rest assured, you'll get your money's worth. Radio show, it had my power at the Yahtzee show. It's a dynamo. The Yahtzee show, it's rock and roll.
He's got running room. Getting around Harris, moving in. Fires! It's 3-2, and Orr has scored a shorthanded goal. His 100th point. That's Bobby Orr's 100th point of the season. No other defenseman in the National Hockey League history has ever done it.
Thank you. Vaseline. We'll perform on guillotine. What a scene, what a scene. Next up on the stand, will you please extend a hand to Alexander's ragtime band, Dixieland, Dixieland. Roll up, roll up, roll up, see the show. Performing on a stool, be a sight to make you drool. Seven virgins on a mule, keep it cool.
I now know for sure that my leg cannot handle playing. If I had to do it all over again, I think I know I would do it the same way. I'm disappointed, but I am relieved. I would not want to go through the rest of my life thinking, well, maybe there was that chance. I now know I'm no longer able to play.
Thank you very much.
Hi, ladies. Can we roll the window down? I'm not going to mug you. They think I'm going to mug them. I won't mug you. I just want to ask you a couple questions about the Bruins. You don't know the Bruins? Oh, you don't know that Byers kid? They gassed me. They gassed me. We'll be right back.
O'Connell coming out. Middleton trying to move right in. Goes a fantastic goal by Rick Middleton. Control of puck in his face. And beat Barron to make it 2-1. Housley. Middleton going. Middleton.
By one man, Van Boxmeer, a boy, a show, and a goal by Bart, all the way from the Bruins end.
Trying to cut in. Hold on, gets it again. He's in. He scores! Steal by Jenny. Jenny in.
Throw me some fish! You button fly? Definitely.
I checked it out. You know what I mean?
One. Oh! Couldn't get any weirder. It did. They even brought their own music.
Awesome! Hey, fellas, how about a cold bud?
A bud?
Obviously, we thought alike.
Oh, that's cold.
You know what I mean?
Obviously, a couple of knowledgeable hockey fans right here. Come on. Hi, girls. What's going on? Don't run away. No, no, wait, wait. No, come on. I just want to ask you a couple of questions. Ooh, that charisma's kicking in. Watch, they dig me. Okay, do you know the Bruins? You know the Bruins? Okay, so who do you think's, like, the hunk on the team?
Cam Neely.
I made you
want some more, baby, before I am through. I want to be yours, pretty baby, yours and yours alone. I'm here to tell you, honey, that I'm bad to the bone, bad to the bone. Fire. Woman beg, and I make a good woman steal. I make an old woman blush, and I make a young girl squeal. I wanna be yours, pretty baby, yours and yours alone. I'm here to tell you, honey, that I'm bad to the bone. Bad, 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 bad to the bone.
Equipment that we never ever can forget.
That's music equipment.
Uh-huh. Game can't go on without it.
This is Neely's favorite one.
This is what inspires Cam Neely, right? Bad to the bone. Bad to the bone.
Bad to the bone. Why bad to the bone?
It's a great tune. You ever heard the tune? Might be a little bit half the year time or whatever, but we got some 50 stuff in there if you want to listen to it.
Retired from playing, Milbury got a desk job as an anchor desk.
Good evening, everybody. I'm Mike Milbury, and this is Sports Channel Update.
Oh, no, you're not going to show clips of that, are you?
You know, if the first day of competition was any indication, the 23rd Olympic Games are well on their way to becoming an unqualified success.
I can remember at the end of the first show, you know, that they were running the credits, but nobody switched my mic off, and I said, you know, and it looked as if I had sneezed instead of the expletive that I used.
Their road trip, but it hasn't helped. The Bruins have worked in a half a dozen faces in the last month and are looking for it to come together in the course of this road trip, which began on a blue note tonight in St. Louis as the Bruins lose 4-0. Some familiar faces in unfamiliar places all over in St. Louis tonight. Adam Oates, interesting scene here, hits Brett Hull, ex-Liney, for a last time. Early on, it was all Andy Moog, first robbing Brett Hull with the glove, coming right back with a huge stick save on him. Moogie looks good, and that's a good sign long-term. Maybe not tonight, but long-term. Early on, a great shot beats him. David Lowry goes over the glove. Good feed from Jeff Brown there. And a little bit later, Michel Mongeau, a rising shot over Andy's shoulder. Two great shots. It's a good sign. If you're going to get beat by a great shot. Now, Curtis Joseph earned the shutout tonight, stopping the NHL's hottest goal scorer. Ended up with 34 saves on the night. Vladdy did not like that. Vladdy's not a happy man right now at all. On to Chicago. Vladdy's still not happy. On to the scoreboard. St. Louis 4, Bruins nothing. Billy Ranford, a big game at Edmonton, 3-1 win over Hartford. Philadelphia, the pesky Flyers over Quebec, 3-2.
We're going to have a surprise for you. We're actually going to go to that Chicago-Los Angeles game.
Oh, we need to, because Wayne Gretzky's sporting a very playoff-like do here. We've got to know who the coiffeur was. Tony Granato cuts in off the wing. Big goal to tie it up early on in a great building, Chicago Stadium. Great building to play in. That is sitting at 2-2 in the third period.
You got to get a picture of this guy. The guy's selling fresh fruit, and he's got a dart hanging out of his mouth. Check it out.
Have you ever wondered who played the organ during the games at the Boston Garden? Who replaced the legendary John Kiley? Well, say hello to Ron Harry, keyboard man for the Boston Garden.
Did he ever take requests?
Oh, sure, all the time. That's how I've been to a lot of Grateful Dead, and I've just added Led Zeppelin. Really, it's fun stuff, you know, but with the people I ask for it, what are you going to do?
So you think you can get the latest George Michael out of this thing before the night's over?
No, I don't, you never know.
I'm a headbanger, man. Give me some Queensryche, something nasty. My favorite tune's like Black Betty. Whoa, Black Betty, bam, bam.
said Ewan's just jockeying. Byers is waiting for one. He wants that uppercut, but Ewan's a big, strong kid. Hey, Mr. Mayor, Mr. McGinn. Oh,
uh-oh.
Lyndon caught him.
Shot.
Lyndon caught him left.
Lyndon Byers with a bad shoulder.
Lyndon Byers got a little bit of a reach on Berube. Got one in there, rattled him. That uppercut had a caught him. Berube would have been in trouble. Now Berube is trying to get a couple in, but Lyndon can fight. Trying to get rid of an elbow pad.
A lot of static from that one. I did a public service announcement with Mike Liut, and they gave me Whalers, and I put it on for 3 shots. I wasn't thinking. I took 3 warm-up shots, and I took it off. I haven't been able to live it down, but now I have Lyndon Byers jersey on, my favorite player, LB. The only guy dislocated his shoulder with a right hook. I like that.
Lyndon Byers, what's the deal with this fight strap thing?
Well, everybody, it's not called a fight strap. It's called a tie-down, and what it does is it doesn't allow you to get your jersey pulled over your head when you're in a beef. Not that I ever am in a beef. What you do is you take your ties, tie it up, put it around your waist, because I tie a string to hold my pants up, snap it up, voila. Okay, pull it over your head. You never get beaten up. Perfect.
Someone that's in the sin bin, what's that?
I'd be getting 5 minutes for fighting. I'd be sitting in the penalty box.
Delivering Steve Casper's laundry bag right now, so that's what it comes to. You do these things for those guys that go out there and work their hearts off.
You mean you didn't come over here to be on camera? You're actually taking the laundry out?
It is amazing. I'm taking Stevie Casper's laundry, but for you, Dave, I would come at any beckoning.
Back.
Once again, Lyndon Byers all by himself. Yes, it's true. Hard to believe such an outgoing person has no friends.
Yes, I won.
Put my fucking car back on the track, will you?
One more lap.
Hi, coach.
Hi, coach.
How are you?
Come on.
You gotta stop.
Yeah,
you
can't.
I'm being
your
two-nothing.
Two-nothing.
Brought your cars with you, huh?
Yeah, we're on the road. We're all set to go.
Tell us when. Oh. I'm shuffling lines around, guys. I'll let you know when I get it straightened out.
Okay, right, coach.
Thanks. See you there, coach.
Five nothing.
Things not working. I don't want to quit. I don't want to play no more.
You broke the darn car. How am I supposed to play?
Things that concerns me, you've talked about this week. Attitude, you know, what's been going on with the club for the last 3 or 4 games. We just haven't got involved physically. And you know what? You've talked enough about it, so we don't have to rally around the flag anymore. You just got to go out and do it.
How is my bus to say that?
I felt good all the way.
Oh, Skankley!
What are you guys doing?
Putting on the foil. Every game.
Yeah, you want some? No.
Miller time.
It's none of that stinking root beer.
Thank you.
Rockefeller. He applauded Robert Ray being sent to the bench.
Right.
And kind of dead on.
Oh, there he goes. He overwhelms him. He's gone.
Yeah.
his office.
Let's go up and see him.
Gotta be a Bruins fan.
I think so.
Now, if they're not, can we get thrown out of there?
Very easily.
Let's do it.
All right. Okay.
Let's try it.
Mayor Flynn.
Ooh.
Hope he likes you, Linda. You know, who doesn't like the kid?
You had a lot of good chance early going in the overtime. You had a lot on the power play. He wants to know, did you want puck?
Yeah, I want puck. Yeah. Every time.
He said he want puck every time. He told me it was the biggest goal he ever scored. He's very happy for the team, and it was his biggest night point-wise in his career in the NHL. But he had one bigger night in Czechoslovakia. I don't know what that was, though. Kiss your stick, though.
All right.
Yeah.
Because.
Oh, you want to kiss mine next game?
Big game?
Yeah.
For Bruins, why?
Why? Two nothing and next two games in Pittsburgh, it's tough. And for the team, it's two nothing, it's very good.
That's good.
Have you had enough now, Vladimir? Do you want to go take a shower? Are you tired?
Yeah, I'm tired.
Vladimir wants to take a shower. All he is pack a lunch, all right?
Over the line, stick handling, shifting, he's in. He scores! Rozichka in a solo rush makes it 4-3 ball foul by Rozichka. He is in. Scores! Rozichka! Boston. out there for Rosicki. He scores from a fantastic angle set up by Leach. Now the pass across, quick shot, score! Ford, for Janney.
Go Bruins.
I'm just a real temporary kind of fair weather fan. When they start losing, believe me, I'm out. I jump ship. So,
you know what I mean?
Janney, Neely, and Nyland. Nyland scored a goal.
I've fallen and I can't get up.
Thanks for stopping by, Rosie. We're glad you're a Bruin, and get back on the ice soon, all right?
Why not? There's nothing preventing them. After all, there's no other pair of Czech brothers who cruise and swing so successfully in tight slacks.
We are two wild and crazy guys!
I'm...
The mayor's not in right now.
The mayor's not in? Does he know who's here to see him?
Hold on.
Just one second. I'm sure we'll slice. As soon as he hears that I'm here, it'll be boom.
Okay.
We may even have dinner here with the mayor if he hears this. Lyndon Byers.
Boston Bruins.
We can get in? Is he here?
Of course he's here.
This is cool. First she said he's not here. Then I toss my name out, right? And it doesn't get around. Come on. I'm here to see the mayor. Right, we're going to get in.
Hold on.
Clean up the mayor's house. Yeah.
Hold on. We'll try to get you in there.
I'm...
You can even sit behind his desk.
Shh. Don't... Steve, he always gives everything away. You know, once you get in there, we can do anything. Look at the... You guys, I'm going to get in the mayor's office.
Riley likes to chat it up while he's playing goal. There we go.
Get him, guys. Go, go, go.
What's he saying?
Go, get him.
Go. It's an over-year term.
Number 35. One, a great save by Lafontaine, two in a row, picks it up, sends it out.
almost.
Mark. Here's Sundstrom walking in. Save by Andy Moe. Kurich dashing back over the line for Lemieux. He's in. Save. Andy Moe came out, cut down the angle on him.
Uh-oh.
Steal by Stewart.
Bruins
have to watch. Here's Linden. Down to right. Oh, it's stopped by Moe.
Can't hit it any harder. I know that.
Outside. Gotcha.
Pass to front. Taylor. Shot. What a stop by Lemlin.
Watch him throw the left feet out, the both feet out. That's what makes it, that right.
Out comes Sackett with Moran. Pass deflected. Save, Lemlin, and Moran has it. And LeFleur gets it. LeFleur puts it in front. Save, and Fogarty. Brown, Brown, right across. Shot. Him away and Wesley, beautiful move with Lemlin. It's Lemlin. There's it outside the line. The coffee way in the shot. Lemlin lost it. That was headed for the top corner. Behind the net. Cullen centering pass. Saved by Moog. And
she took my heart.
to go. Puck in the corner. Poked in front. Mario Lemieux.
Great goaltending duo of Andy Moog and Reggie Lemelin won the Jennings Trophy.
You know, a lot of people ask us if we're the oldest goaltending duo in the league. And Cam Neely calls Andy Daddy, and he calls me, you guessed it, Grandpa, so you figure it out.
Okay. They're old timer. Need all the help I can get here.
These are the pipes. And the guy who stands between them is the
goalie. The idiot.
You're a goalie. You're supposed to be like that.
Sports talk.
Hi, Jim Carrigan. Dennis, I know that some in our audience don't know the finer points of hockey. Could you tell them, for example, what is icing?
Well, icing happen when the puck come down, bang, you know, before the other guys, nobody there, you know. Mm-hmm. My arm go comes out, then the game stopped and start up.
Mm-hmm. I see. What is high sticking?
High sticking happen when the guy take the stick, you know, and he go like that. You know, you don't do that.
You don't do that?
Oh, no, never, never.
Why not?
Against the rules. You know, you're stupid when you do that. Just some English pig with no brain
Dennis,
at all, you know.
What is slashing?
Slashing is like that, you know.
Mm-hmm. And there's a penalty for that?
Yeah. And for a trip also, you know, like that. And for hook, like this. And for spear, you know, like that. Mm-hmm. All bad.
Bad.
You do that, you go to the box, you know, 2 minutes by yourself, and you feel shame, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And then you get free.
You pull one thing, you're out of this game. Now I run a clean game here. I have any trouble, I'll suspend you. I'm looking at a fucking song!
The defeat of New Jersey featured Jim Schoenfeld, the irate coach of the Devils, and Don Kohaski, the plump referee, in the celebrated donut controversy.
You're crazy!
I'm not open, John Pig!
You're crazy! You're good because you fell, you fat pig! Have another donut! Have another donut!
Here's Boston's Mike Milbury telling the ref very calmly how he appreciates the great job he's doing that night. Folks, I really don't know where Mike learned all that stuff. I was really shocked when I saw that. Nice jacket, though. Here I am, standing on my desk for the overflow reporters that come in after every game. They couldn't fit in my tiny office Harry Sinnott gave me. Now, not only do you have to make yourself available to the reporters, you must always speak to them in gracious terms and know what the right thing to say at the right time. Now, watch.
John, you're getting on my nerves, I'll tell you that right now.
All right,
pray with you want, John.
Your team humiliated in there?
Don't be a jerk. I mean, humiliated? What do you mean? For 30 minutes, we outplayed them, and then all of a sudden, we, for understandable reasons, we blow our composure. That's a stupid question.
How do you solve Billy Ray?
It's a stupid game?
Yeah. Well, you're a stupid reporter.
Now, you'd think that most reporters would pretty much let it lie for there, but not this specific Cub reporter, who I guess never saw Milbury going to the stands after fans in his day. Now, listen to his next question.
From our hard forechecking game.
Was it that your luck ran out against Montreal?
Thank you.
And he does involve himself enthusiastically, which is why he can appreciate fully what his team has accomplished.
Teams mirror their coach's personality. No coach anywhere has more desire or determination than Terry O'Reilly.
All right, finish off the check, boys. Right across.
Fantastic. Go, Willie, go.
Let's go, let's go. Three forwards.
Come on, Terry, let it go.
Deep down, boys, deep down.
Even I used to get upset a little. Great suit, eh? Medill threw me out and Jerry Cheevers, the backup goalie, coached his first game.
And now, folks, it's time for a little musical interlude.
He's a man behind the mic and he loves a good fight.
Got his own set of words and they come out just right.
He's a hockey man seen coast to coast.
And if you don't go in corners, he hates you the most.
Grapes!
I'll tell you something right now.
Grape Jam!
I played the minor leagues. I coach the Boston Bruins. If you're asking me, I think the game's in ruins. Guys don't fight. They don't fact check. It's like watching the Nordiques out there in Quebec.
Great!
Now, let me tell you something right now, because,
Great Jam! He's got a 6-inch collar. He's no Kareem Buff.
He likes to shout and holler when he sees rough stuff.
Some say he's nasty, say he shouldn't be hurt.
When it comes to hockey, he gets the last word.
Great!
I'm gonna tell you something, and it's the God's honest truth.
Great Jam!
I'll tell you something else. Pfizer's no good. Don't like them.
Great!
Von Helleman, worst ref I've ever seen.
Great Jam!
Europe, it's a nice place to visit, but just stop sending us hockey players, all right?
Great!
That's Joey Koester. He'll drop him with just about anyone.
Great Jam!
Only guys who don't like fighting are you press types. I'll tell you that right now.
Great! Great.
Well, this is the point at which Don usually goes. First of all, before we go any further...
Right. You know...
Okay,
Wait a minute, I'm not through yet.
Well, ask me the questions. That's
okay.
Your job.
Before we get started...
I'll tell you something about this guy.
Well, you know, I...
Dopey.
Whammo.
This is only 3 minutes, eh?
You know, people must wonder about what's going on. Let me just tell you, our friends, the Russians, 5 of them were in the playoffs. They played 23 games, and they had no goals.
But quite a few assists.
11. They had 11 assists.
Who's counting?
I knew this guy would say that. 11 assists. 11 assists, and they took back their $6 million.
I have the microphone over here. Not to gamble with Slats Machine, according to Don Cherry, in this installment of the Coach's Corner.
It that brought all this on was the Brown thing, and it was stupid. He should never have done it. And a 2-2 tie with the referee standing there even made it worse. That shows you his mentality. But let's quit picking on hockey. It's not that bad.
Well, Matt Snazlin, I think, raised
Matt
a great point.
Matt Snazlin? Of course he doesn't like the banging and the smashing. Why would he? He's only this high. But, you know, there's a big bodies out there, 200 pounds, and, you know, all you have to do is hit them. And when you hit them, you don't have to maim them, but hit them to hurt. I mean, nobody's afraid out there. That game tonight, Winnipeg, are you kidding me? They look like nothing either. Nobody hits anybody. Look like a tea party out there. Look, Swedes and Finns playing at December. Nothing, no hitting. Then you go down and you watch Pittsburgh and Canadians, wango. That's hockey. It's no hitting. If a guy can't score, then he bring up guys that are supposed to be tough, and they bring guys tough and they lay on the ice and they don't fight. They don't do anything. I mean, hit or fight or do something.
Toronto Maple Leafs have won 4 in a row at home and maybe on their way to a fifth.
Wendell Clark is a better hockey player with half a back than most guys is with full back.
Most guys are. Wendell Clark is a big goal for Wendell. Clearly, he's
now
still
he's
bothered by this.
Literary giant here.
Proper
literary
grammar
giant.
Is important. You're setting an example to many young Canadians, and I think.
Yeah, well, I'm rich. I'm richer than you, and you can speak, right? So don't start telling me how to speak. I can count. So go ahead.
Okay, let's count.
Whatever it takes.
Come on down.
Right away, boys. Go for the jungler, boys.
I'll know how to play hockey. Just play it smart.
That's right.
You know, Jared, stick him.
Fuck him, Christ, pop him.
Right here, Charlotte, let's go.
Come on.
Let's go now.
We need this win, you know. We got a lot of losses to.
Yeah, we got a lot of losses. Let's start making up for it. Let's start winning.
Go to the top.
At the bottom.
That's what we're here for, guys, to win.
Play heads up out there. I mean, let's be smart. Man for man, we're better than any fucking club in the league. And let's put our minds to it.
We're number one. We're number one.
Come on, Braden, our line starts.
Come on.
I'm a real wild one.
Wild one.
Wild one.
Wild one.
Just let me know if you wanna go to that whole mile on the range. They got a lot of nice girls.
I'm ready.
How?
saw a stick hit him. There's the puck up in the stick base. The whole guard is safe.
Too close to the scene, probably. Call it, but he didn't put the hand up.
No call from whole guard, so I'll give you a mind. Oh, there you go. Nice little left hook. Then he went down.
But he spared him with the stick.
No, he fell on him.
Down and hurt.
Make the fucking head.
Nail him, make his mind.
Size, he deserves it.
The Bruins of 1970 would simply squash teams with their explosive attack. They were dubbed the big, bad Bruins, brawling as often as scoring.
But he was also a hothead with a short fuse and is best remembered more for his infamous shoe incident in New York than his defensive skills. So it is somewhat ironic that this is the same person who today preaches the value of restraint.
Let me tell you something. If Dale Hunter ever did what he did to Wesley and Mike was on the ice, there'd been a riot.
The fans are standing up to them. The security guards are standing up to them. The peanut vendors are standing up to them. And by God, if I could get down there, I'd be standing up to them.
Yeah. Kids in the mayor's office. Holy cow. This is Margaret's office right here. Did I mention that Margaret's looking tremendous today? How about the gold? Gold. Gold's beautiful. Look at this.
Look at this office.
This is great.
I think this guy can help you.
He's cool.
This is amazing. He's got a TV. Tune in to Bruins games.
Yeah. Mayor Flynn's office, everybody. Watch us. Okay, wait. I got to get out of here, but this is the mayor's chair. I'm pumped. Thanks. We'd like to thank Mayor Flynn and everybody here at the office, and we're big supporters, and I hope that he's the mayor forever and ever. Margaret, you're a babe. We love you.
Number 77, Captain Ray Bourque.
Trees, Ray Bourque has and always will be the Bruins' Redwood. But have you ever noticed what Ray does right before and after the national anthems every game? First, he blesses his goalie. Then after the anthem, he blesses himself, touches the face-off circle, and traverses the blue line. Hey, Ray, what's the deal with this ritual?
As athletes, I think when you get into a routine and you get doing the same thing every night, it just comes as a habit, and you just do it.
And just as we expect to find him parked beside Reggie Lemelin before the start of every period, preparing himself, as he always does, for the next 20 minutes of hockey.
I call it a routine. More than superstitious. I don't know why I do it. I just do it because I've been doing it for quite a few years now. No matter who's in goal, I do it.
Do you say anything to him?
These days, yeah, we say something in French before every game. But I can't say it on air because you wouldn't understand it. But if there's any French viewing people out there, they'll understand it, and it's not something that I'd like them to hear.
While what he says before each period will remain a mystery, what he'd like to say after the season is that the Bruins are the best.
That's what I'm hoping for. That's what I want. I just want a shot, and I want to go out there and do it. And it feels great. I'm having a lot of fun. I'll tell you, I beat Montreal. That was a lot of fun. But our next quest is winning that Stanley Cup.
Oh, no, shoot,
you're okay.
Got stuff under your shoes already.
Where? Babe. Chick from Babylonia. Hi. How you doing? You're pretty happy. Where are you heading? Airlines, stewardess, and pilots, and everything. Where are you all from?
Well, I'm from Washington, D.C.
Washington, wow. Do you guys know anything about the Bruins?
Yes.
They kicked the Capitals' butt.
Hey.
But you know, wheeling in front. All of them, Steve Hines scores! The winner, his first goal as a Bruin, Steve Hines! And Boston beat Buffalo 4-3! He gets it in front, alone. Score by Donato! The Bruins win it! Ted Donato from Rosicka! The Bruins win it 5-4!
They get up every morning from the alarm clock's warning. Take the 8:15 into the city. There's a whistle up above and people pushing, people shoving, and the girls who try to look pretty. And if your train's on time, you can get to work by 9.
To get it out in front. Neely behind the screen. He's high! Bob Sweeney wins it in overtime.
This would be the ambition. You could be a musician if you could make sound loud or mellow.
Sweeney
gives the Bruins the victory 5-4. They get a
Roy spells boy and Gio Y spells toy. Then why does Roy spell Roy? Good point. I always call him Patrick Roy. But it's French, Roy. Means king, I guess.
R-O-I.
R-O-I is how you spell it, however.
The game?
Still looks like Patrick Roy to me.
Yeah?
But he's certainly... I thought it was Roy was R-O-I.
But, you did.
Well, I would say that would be the pronunciation of spelling.
Their signature, written in flames as well as tears, was the glorious Too Many Men on the Ice fiasco in the Montreal Forum. To be sure, there were too many of them out there, six skaters waltzing about for fully 10 seconds, trying to protect a one-goal lead in the last minutes against the Canadiens, with a winner sure to win the cup. The rest, as they say, is history.
Leads Lemaire. Back to Lafleur, the shot forward, Guy Lafleur. Conley breaks with Lambert at far left. Conley moving deep. Centers it.
I never seen a team try so hard and not win. It was just, I mean, I want to cry for them. I look at them and I feel so much for them. That they were great. I never seen a team try so hard.
45 years of dust, man! Go.
puts it across in front. It is Bork fighting for it into the corner, behind the net to Brickley. Brickley holding in front. Billy scores! Cam Neely from Andy Brickley to tie the game at two with 2:06 left. He is hit on the play. Here comes Wesley over the line. Ludwig fell down. Wesley moving in. Shot scores! Wesley scores! And the Bruins lead 3-2!
This is not a pleasant experience for Montreal, but one man's bitter is often another's sweet.
I'm ashamed.
Not you, Coach.
Yeah, really ashamed of myself. See, Ned was right. Violence is killing this sport, it's dragging it through the mud. If things keep up the way they are, hockey players will be nothing but actors, punks. Well, I'm not playing my last game that way.
Last game?
Yeah, it's my last game, and I want to play it straight. And no more nail him, no more fuck with him, that's finished. I want to win that championship tonight, but I want to win it clean. Old-time hockey. Like when I got started, you know? Jesus, Toe Blake, Dick Clapper, Eddie Shore, those guys were the greats. Well, I don't know what to say. Christ, it's up to you.
Well, Reg is our coach.
Yeah, sure, old-time hockey.
Like Eddie Shore.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Thank you. To Stanfield, to McKenzie, shooting, he scores! John McKenzie!
let's join our modern day crew as they appeared in 72.
Who's here? Mr. Colitis himself, Derek Sanderson. How does it feel, Derek?
Now you got to bring up my medical problem. That's embarrassing.
I'm sorry. And we'll forget all about him now. How about this hockey game? It was tough. What about the fight with Gilbert?
That was like the mafia. It was nothing personal, strictly business. It was nothing personal. Marcotti got a penalty, and we were a man short, and Gilbert plays a power play, and he plays it very well. And I figured, I knew I was going to fight with him 15 feet before I hit him, you know. And I fought him intentionally for that purpose of getting him off the ice during that power play. And, you know, as little as I played, I just tried to fight as many people as I could to keep him off the ice. So.
Well, the penalty killing was superb. A shutout shows that. Eddie's kind of a third defenseman out there. How do you evaluate yourself on it?
I just give the puck to Bobby Orr.
Well, that's it, folks. Hope you enjoyed the tape as much as Blue and I did doing it for you. See you later, folks. Thanks for watching.